Hello viewers and welcome to the maiden edition of the program, The Pyramid. My name is Emma Agwaya Onyini. The Pyramid is a general overview program born out of passion and desire to help change and reorient the minds and beliefs, norms and values of the society. It also prepares us to see the world and the existence of man beyond the ordinary.
The Pyramid. See the life beyond the ordinary.
With me on today's program is Mr. Charles Ezema Nnayereugo. You're welcome, sir, to the program.
Thank you. Yes.
The 30 minutes program will be targeting the youth, the faith-based organization, the family, and the society. I urge you viewers to sit tight as Mr. Ezema Charles Nnayereugo will educate us more. Sir, the ball is now on your court.
Thank you very much, viewers. This is the inaugural presentation of what I call a pyramid. A pyramid, you know, it's a concave arrangement, and it's targeting the mind of God in my own mind, and interpretation of guiding instruments in different paradigms in this universe. This is the maiden edition of my art creation, because it's going to be very educated on our societal interactions. But permit me to start from what we all know about God's vision of man as espoused in the Bible. It's elucidated very clearly in Genesis 1 and 2 about the purpose of man in God's eyes. Okay. Let me hazard something that in the mind of God, man, woman, with food and other resources, they have their children. These children will grow up in the wisdom given by these people. So the limitation of the family is about the vision of these two people. In Nigeria, 200 million of these members of families. In the world, 9 million. But in God's eye, in creating the male first, he knew he had a purpose for man, but that the man needs a woman who is carrying an egg so that they can farm and produce this child. That's God's vision. Okay, I've talked about God and man. Now I'm going to talk about the relationship between God and the universe. A spherical creation in the mind of God with a lot of things inside it. 7 continents surrounded by other constellations, moon, stars, and sunlight, all running around it. What is doing them? I don't know. 7 continents inside this place. Now, inside this continent, we have different governments, about 190 of them, as in the last statistics about the General Assembly, 196 members of world governments. What are they going to do around this 7 continents? They are trying to give this to this people. That is essential business of government and the world. Okay, let me ratchet this continent to be Africa. In Africa, we have world governments, developing democracies, military dictatorship, despotic regimes, or navigating leadership to their people. I told you in the world, man, I think Africa has one third of the world population. So, gentlemen, I have a fairly good idea of God's intention for man as encapsulated in this guiding instrument, the Bible. From my little knowledge, assuming we say this is God, omnipotent, omnipresent, and so on, his vision of man is here. I will create a man in my own image. I will also be offering Eve. Two of them will look for food, and with this egg in the man's stomach and the little resources around them, raise children. The standard for a standard number of children, internationally recognized, is 4, because of world hunger and other strategies to stop man from overproducing. In Nigeria, 200 million as of today, individuals. In the world, 9 billion. Because if you look at the comparative analysis of world economies, the aggregate of the GDP of world government all over, you understand that developed countries control more of world resources than developing countries. Okay, I've taken on the family as in God's mind. Let me look at and see whether I can perceive God's impression about what he created. He created a spherical object called Earth. This Earth has a lot of constellation running around it, the moon, the sun, the stars, and so on. And they go in a concentric circle by God's all-powerful algorithm. So inside this world, we have 7 continents ranging from Asia to Africa. So I come to Africa. I step it down to one country called Nigeria. But suffice it to say that in this algorithm, it's all about mankind. How can world governments with different populations, like I said, Nigeria is 200 million, others and so on and so on, how can they give effective leadership to their people? In world democracies like Norway, they have a very excellent planning system that carry the population. In more or less developed economies, planning is a Herculean task. But let us say we come to Nigeria. In Nigerian government, let me take it to where you can understand it properly. We have Mr. President, the executive arm. We have Mr. Senate President, the legislative and the judiciary. These are the 3 layers of government that will cascade under the president, who is the CEO. You have the vice president, you have secretary to the government, and you have at various levels about 17 or 18 federal parastatals in the eye of Nigerian constitution. I think this one has A to I. So these people are supposed to play with an instrument, another instrument called Nigerian Constitution. This Nigerian Constitution has a lot of specifications that should guide every Nigerian or anybody that is there within the entity called Nigeria. Fine. So you are playing with this Constitution. In this Constitution, you are playing with another one. If you are in public service, and what is it? You are going to play with this. That's a financial regulation. He said, it must however be noted that the financial regulation, though designed and composed for government businesses, are relevant to both private and public companies, sole administratorship and partnership. So this is critical instrument in the organization of your business or in running on government. You cascade it to this place. You have other factors you are using to play. They call it public service rule. If you are going to run civil servants, this is the law. If you are going to touch government money, that's the one. There are other laws that you need to do. Even if you have a lot of contracts, SEGE, a lot of contracts. What is the contract that are holding this entity? What are the instruments that people playing in this entity must respect and obey? They are critical. Okay. I leave it at federal because I can still go on and say federal parastatals asking account, who is the accounting officer, who is the political head, how they interact within that environment is very critical. So let me look at local governments, rather states first. I'll come to local government. This is an executive governor of the state. This is a deputy. This is secretary to the government. And you have your commissioners. How many do you need in an entity? That is determined by the law guiding them. And the commissioners are in charge of ministries and so on and parastatals. All of them are in government for the sole purpose of these people. Masses. So I think in this paradigm, if I should look at Ebonyi, the projected population of Ebonyi is 5 million. The total population of Nigeria is 200 million. So what is the percentage of 5 million in 200 million? It will determine. So these people come and play with the national resources. So having talked about the world and the dynamics and interplay and the directions of variables, I also talked about, you know, de-escalating it to Nigeria, the levels of government and how they can play using various instruments. I now go to state, like I said, I've said government, executive government. How they run this government is also a function of this this and other laws made in their own paradigm based on their specific environment. Okay, I've not left out an aspect there, the church. This family goes to church here. And this church here is interpreting the mind of God to this population. As many as come, will be either on weekly or on daily basis. And the central point is the moral values to this family system, moral values. So we have at the top in the Catholic Church, you have the Pope, you have the Bishop in charge of paradigms, and whatever. You have Reverend Fathers, and so right up to my village here, the priest, and all the people that go there. Then, these people, family, how do they play so that they can play well and play here, or go into small businesses around? What skill are you imbibing into these children so that they can come out and play? If our constitution says 18 years, what values are you going to inculcate into this child to be strong enough to play in the wider world with a lot of instruments? Which means the child must know all these instruments to be a strong player. So let us look at what you need to put into these children as they grow up. You have education, you have health, you have agriculture, you have education, and so on. All those all these very important parameters for producing an excellent child that can play this play. Because this play is very difficult. World governments are making best possible means of making their own best. Some even take children as soon as they are born and start taking care of their feeding, their education, their health, this thing, so that the family will not indoctrinate them. So what are we doing our own? We need careful planning to stay afloat. 200 million Nigerians without proper training at the family level will ratchet up trouble even in Nigeria or anywhere in the world. Because you need to have correct algorithm to play in this perfect place called world. Okay, let me go to the associations that can enable the church, the family, and anyone to go across the issues. This is a very big gulf for you to cross them. Okay, let me look at those associations. You come here, you have association of agri people to assist people to get finance. You have another one to give you good crops and good yield. You have another one, parenthood, planning for family, contraception, and so on. You have those ones now, helping young girls to think less about pleasure and think more of skill, helping the women to know their own algorithm. You have it on men. You have it on all facets of life. These are associations. Funded by international bodies and people with very good heart. They create it with their first earning. They not grow it over time. They die away, their children take it. And their job is to help mankind. So what is the essence of what I want to say? Let me latch on critical creations in the past that also helped me when I was growing up. And that is why this one came as an inspiration. When I was growing up, I can hardly sleep without watching the masquerade. Zebudiah Okoriwemo and his English that is all positive. And let us Mulukosa Kokro Adore. These are programs in the 90s and the 80s that give you joy. That was when Nollywood was at infancy. And let us also look at Checkmate. Each of these targets a group of Nigerians and they ratchet up the best as they grew up. I can still stay today and say something that was said in the Kokro Adore. And the man wanted to play one beautiful novel whistle class. He said, Titin Ablation. Beautiful English. And he would say something like, this is the product of my endeavor, the materialization of my inventive genius, and all that. We laughed about it and crammed it. These were played out in those 80s and 90s. Families were much more happy. Families were closely knitted. They came close to answer a call. This time, they are all gone apart with their phones in different directions. You can even walk into your home now and greet your wife and your children. And all of them will just be treated. They're doing like this. What a shift. That is why I'm launching this, or rather I'm cascading this passionate program to see whether I can create knowledge in a critical mass of viewers that can change their mindset and perception of this world. It's a challenging place, it's beyond sweet bread and granite. You need to play and play with skill. If you have ever watched World Cup, I watched Croatia and Nigeria. Kai! Croatia were playing Nigeria football. They had strength, they had grace, they had intelligence, they had structures, they had missing their eye contact, their body language, but Nigeria couldn't compete. What happened? They will go on a run, bada, 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 and somebody will break that ball and stop it and pass it back, and all of them will be breathing. And Christians are just like this, waiting for the ball to come out. I think they just gave us two. I thought they would have given us more. In fact, I had to take my drug that day because that match was too much for me. So, gentlemen, I want to tell you that I'm going to make sure that a generation will see this as I saw in the 80s and 90s and learn from it. It's all powerful. It's going to be educative. And I'm going to ratchet all sorts of strategies so that the mind of the viewer will be blown to understand the lubricants of life in the very small way I studied, and it has helped me. So, in God's name, I pray that I'll continue to grow critical listeners that can go and research after each presentation, and then you also try to reason more. The society is the perception about our life today has been diminished and reduced. Unless we ratchet it and raise it up, the future of our youth are in jeopardy. So I want to thank you very much for this inaugural program, hoping that as we go more and more, I'll be able to research and to give Nigerians the kind of stories I was told growing up. We all gathered in one small tree in the village, Ogara, and elderly people would tell us beautiful stories, and we were asked to recite after it. All of us grew wiser. And there was this resonance of tortoise, tortoise, tortoise. And all of us were looking out to be tortoises as we grow. And we pray that we create more tortoises in the day and the week and the month to come. I thank you very much for being your guest today. Thank you very much. I'm so happy.
The Pyramid. See the life beyond the ordinary.
Wow, it's been an interesting program with Mr. Charles Ezemadinale. Mr. Charles, we really commend you for today's program. But I want to ask, you said something about tortoise and creation. Could you please explain further?
Yes, in the African mythology, tortoise is a symbol of knowledge, a very sensible animal likened to a sensible human. For all the stories told by our fathers under the Odara tree, Dr. Thor has played a very prominent role in dealing with world problems in a very simple, commonsensical way. Common sense. And suffice it to say that short stories said ever after lashed on that model. I kept taking stories about short drama series as we are growing that shaped our minds, shaped our social interactions, educated us, and then created a very big image of what we want to be. If you do not have models, start thinking about models, because it helps in your being. It goes into your it, your mind development process, and ratchet it to really your dream, and then bring your dream to bear and bring your dream down. And that's why they keep saying, any man that does not dream is just not complete. So, in answering your question about the tortoise and creation, it represents a sound algorithm of a perfect mind, a well-rounded mind, the mind we can only see in an omnipotent, in the mind of a liberated mind that has a balance in all forces of the mind, body, and soul. That is the complete man. So tortoise is that complete man and can solve problems, not giving excuses. Because if we are talking about an equation, 27 is equals to A, B, C, D. If you don't resolve A, B, C, D, you can never know what 27 is. So, excuse is A, B, C, D. Solution is 27.
Okay. Finally, from your analogy, where do we go from here?
Oh, beautiful question. Beautiful question. In the days and weeks and months to come, I've given an impression of where we'll go. We want to create a paradigm shift in our in perception of humans here about the concept of living. It's beyond sweet and chewing gum. That is what I said. I'm just using a lubric of a very low desire to a very high desire of people who are playing here, world leaders. Solving the problem of humanity. About 200 or 250 members of the United Nations created an impression of world problems captured under 8 algorithms, world problems. If I can remember some of them, environmental protection, 2, diseases, health problems, poor education, poor parameters of living. And all of them are aggregating this problem within their own entities and ratcheting solutions get there. So I think that in the days and weeks to come, we will focus on God's mind, family. What went wrong in this family system that we're having a lot of Igba football now? What I mean by Igba football is, in football, you play within a rectangle. If you play the ball out of this rectangular court field, imagine Igba football field, and the consequences are obvious. If you get 2 yellow cards, the next thing that will follow will be a red card. So human beings who are playing in various algorithms, they get 2 yellow cards, they run away, 3, they run away, nobody's bringing them to justice. And that is the root cause of all these problems. People are not being sanctioned for obvious infractions. Violations are becoming the way of living. Nobody charges this individual that is greeting his friend on highways for traffic offense. Nobody is punishing this person that is beating up the wife in the home, creating unnecessary violence. Nobody is punishing people for nuances all over the place. And the society is being degraded at all levels. If you go to our prisons, you may take pity on humanity. People do things without recourse to any guiding instrument. Look at this. I have my Bible. I have my criminal law in Nigeria. I have the Nigerian land law. I have Nigerian law of contract. I have administrative law. I have Nigerian constitutional law. I have libel and the press. I'm educating myself so that as I go out, I stay within the confines of my wing. It don't begin to nebulously move from one wing. That's why even in civil service we have something called schedule of duty. People should confine themselves to their children. You can't move it from one other to the other and another. And it's becoming terrible and it's anarchy all over the place. So I do hope that this little education, when we all understand it and play within this law, then there will be a reduction in the level of crime. There will be a reduction in the level of poverty. There will be a reduction in the hope that you want to live your life and in a minute to take it and ratchet yourself off this earth. Who knows why God created us? So this is what we want to put in the mind of our youth. To be focused so that as they play, whether 60 years on earth, 70 years on earth, they will be able to play within the guiding instrument and have vision and mission in their own paradigms. So the essence of this is to look at family is the basic family. Because the problem of this is the problem of this society. They are also the problem of this world. You see, emphasis hitherto was placed on skill acquisition, education, and talent. This is the only way you can get money. But the youth of today are not getting it. They are not having any talent. And they want money. How? So the algorithm is disproportionately disarrayed. You must identify where you're going, and you take cue and take a direction and coordinates to the place. I want to go to Lagos, and I bought a bus to cross here. Am I going to Lagos? I'm not going to Lagos. So people go to wrong places to seek for solution. Somebody is hungry, and he goes to church to pray. To do what? Go to the farm and farm, so that you can create necessary ingredients and condiments that will give you food. So permit me to say that in the days and weeks ahead, I will structure the presentation. I will narrow into specifics of all this. In the areas we'll be talking about, what is the problem? What methodology are we going to use in solving this problem? What are the findings? How do we critically address the issues? When world leaders sit to discuss problems associated with a given entity, they look at their vision and ambition, look at strategies achieving their objective. So having said that, I want to conclude this inaugural session by saying that God will give us the enablement and strength to move from strength to strength and step to step. Thank you.
Wow, dears. It will allow him to go on and on. We won't leave this place because of time. Oh, Mr. Charles Ezema, I really commend you for educating us more in this program. Viewers, I believe you've learned so much from this program. I enjoin you to join us same time, same station for another interesting edition. Bye for now.